Okay, yesterday class we discussed about the routing protocols introduction. Today I want to share you that we're coming to the classification. We have four types of classifications. One is based on the updating information, and second one is the temporary information, and third one is topology, and the fourth one totally depends on the resources. So we already discussed the based on the routing information update mechanism. We have proactive, reactive, and hybrid routing protocols. And coming to the based on the temporary information for routing. So temporal information of the routing, the name itself has a temporal information that tells about the how the routing protocol will be function here. So it will be classification of based on the ad hoc wireless networks are highly dynamic, and path breaks are much more frequently in than the wired network. So temporary information regarding the lifetime of the wireless links and the lifetime of the path selected assume significance. So manaku wireless networks lo always path will be frequently breakdown will be take space. So based on that only the temporal information of the lifetime of the wireless link that will be connected with the node to the node. So based on that lifetime will be decided, and also lifetime of the path selected assume significantly which will be successful or not. So here there are two categories of classified the temporal information of the routing. One is routing protocol using the past temporal information, and second one is routing protocol that use future temporal information. So there are two temporal informations anedi tisukunnam, one past one future temporal information anedi. So past information ante previous already then data ni transmit chesunte, then again that data will be reused that particular path for the transmission of the source to the destination. So that is the information here. So the routing protocols use the information about the past status of the links or status of the links at time of routing to make the routing decision. For example, routing metric based on the availability of the wireless links along with the shortest path finding algorithm, providing the path that may be efficient and stable at the time of path finding, and topology changes may immediately break the path and making the path undergo to the resources wise expansive path recognition process. So man correct path to present path anedi already ongoing process anedi jarugutunde. Okay, ongoing process ayipoyina tarvata even the path will be breakdown whenever you are changing the topology. Immediately they will be choose the what is the shortest path among the existing path. Okay, based on that only you can use the resources wise expansive path recognition process. They will be recognized by the based on that. Okay, and coming to the routing protocol that use the future. So protocol belong to the category use the information about the expected future status of the wireless links to make approximate routing decision. So our future decision may depend on present decision as consideration this one. So the lifetime of the wireless links and for future status information along the information regarding to the lifetime of the node and the prediction of the location and prediction of the link availability. So lifetime of the node anedi ela cheptunnamante a link anedi within 10 seconds it will be expire. So the path will be the node will be moving from one that point to another point within the 10 seconds. So you can decide whether it is adjusted or not. So that will be represented here. And prediction of the location. So prediction of the location also be based on the future. Okay, here it will become. Okay, here they can identify the prediction of the node across that particular point. So prediction of the link availability also be decided by the future temporal information. So that is the importance of the temporal information. Past information may depend on present connection anedi tisukuntam. అలానే ప్రీవియస్ కేసెస్ ని బేస్ చేసుకొని లైఫ్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్ ది లింక్స్ అనేది డిసైడ్ చేసుకుంటుంది. సో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ద డిసిషన్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్ విల్ బి టేకెన్. సో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది రూటింగ్ టోపాలజీ. సో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది రూటింగ్ టోపాలజీ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ ద ఇంటర్నెట్ ఈజ్ హైరారికల్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు రిడ్యూస్ ద స్టేట్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ మెయింటైన్ అట్ ద కోర్ రూటర్స్. సో వాంట్ టు రిడ్యూస్ ద information maintained across the core routers, we use the routing topologies. So if the based on the topologies, that will be helpful to reduce the data transmission of the control packets. So ad hoc wireless network, due to their relative smaller number of nodes, can make use of the flat topology or hierarchical topology routing. So here also we can divide it into two classifications of the topology. So one is a flat topology and another is hierarchical topology protocols. So flat topology routing protocol, the protocols that fall under the category may use the flat addressing schemes similar to the one used in the IEEE 802.3 LANs. So LANs or IEEE 802.3 LANs, addressing flat addressing bases, the flat topologies can this one. It assumes the presence of the globally unique addressing mechanism. So at least unique to connected path of the network will be takes place. So that is the representation here from the nodes in the ad hoc network. So hierarchical routing. So this belongs to the use of the, logical hierarchical in the network and an associated addressing scheme. The hierarchy could be based on the geographical information or it will be based on the hop distance. Okay, hierarchical information, so that will be based on the geographical information or it will be based on the hop distance. That will be node to node connection. Okay, so that is the hierarchical routing. This is the third type of category in the routing protocols. And based on the utilization of the specific resources. Power-aware routing, this category of the routing protocol aims to minimize the consumption of the very important resources in the ad hoc wireless networks. The battery power, the routing decision are based on the minimizing the power consumption either locally or globally in the network. So power-aware routing anedi utilization of the specific resources ante manam ee type of resources routing purpose ki use chestunnam aa resources ni base cheskon kuda the protocol will be function so here we have used the power aware routing and geographical information assisted routing. Okay, two bases me this geographical information anedi ingoti power awareness anedi. So this category aims to minimize the consumption of the very important resources of the ad hoc network, that is battery power. So battery power enta takku use chestam takku unnatuga protocol anedi design chestam. So routing decision are based on the minimizing the power consumption either locally or globally in the network. So these type of protocols which will be used to reduce the power consumption for the transmission of the data, and also they will provide the path between the source to the destination. Okay, and geographical information assisted routing protocol. So here protocols belongs to the category improve the performance of the routing and reduces the control overheads by efficiently utilizing the geographical information available. So based on the geographical information availability, they will be improves the throughput of the system, and also they will be reduces the control overhead packets that will be utilized for the source to the destination. Okay, that is the information about the geographical information assisted routing. So it will be follows the classifications so far, four categories, utilization of the resources and topologies, and they will be supported for the temporal information and information updating protocols. ఈ ఫోర్ కేటగిరీస్ కింద మనం ఇది చెప్పుకుంటాం. ఓకేనా? ఫస్ట్ ది టేబుల్ డ్రైవెన్ రూటింగ్ ప్రోటోకాల్స్. టేబుల్ డ్రైవెన్ రూటింగ్ ప్రోటోకాల్స్ అనొచ్చు లేదా ప్రొయాక్టివ్ రూటింగ్ ప్రోటోకాల్స్ అని అనుకోవచ్చు. ఓకే, ఎలాగైనా క్వశ్చనింగ్ అనేది ఉంటుంది. ఓకేనా? ప్రొయాక్టివ్, రియాక్టివ్, హైబ్రిడ్. మనం ఫస్ట్ కేటగిరీలోకి వచ్చేసరికి టేబుల్ డ్రైవెన్ రూటింగ్ ప్రోటోకాల్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ప్రొయాక్టివ్. రియాక్టివ్కి వచ్చేసరికి ఆన్ డిమాండింగ్ రూటింగ్ ప్రోటోకాల్స్. ఈ విల్ ఆస్క్ ఎనీ టైప్, ఓకే, క్వశ్చనింగ్ విల్ బి డిఫరెంట్. యూ మస్ట్ బి నో వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాట్. ఓకే, and this protocol extension of the wired network routing protocols. It maintains the global topology information in the form of tables at every node in the particular ad hoc wireless networks. So, prati oka ad hoc wireless network lo, they will be maintains the global information of the in the form of the tables. Okay, and these tables are updated frequently in over the order of maintaining the consistent and accurate network system state information. So always they will be maintain the updated information of the particular states. Under the destination sequenced vector routing protocol and wide routing protocol, source tree adaptive routing protocol, cluster head gateway switching routing protocol. These are the examples of the table driven routing protocol. Proactive example which is like DSDV, WRP, star and CGSR. These are the examples. You must be know about the shortcuts and full forms. Okay, first one, the DSDV, destination sequence distance vector routing protocol. Destination sequence distance vector routing protocol. So destination routing protocol is the one of the first protocol that will be proposed for the ad hoc wireless network. So earliest protocol which is a destination routing protocol, the first protocol can the announcement and this component. It is an enhanced version of the distributed Bellman Ford algorithm where each node maintains a table that consists of the shortest distance. So it will be represented the some distributed Bellman Ford algorithm. Based on that only, they will be maintain the every node table with a short distance and first node on the shortest path to the every other node in the network. So first node nunchi shortest path edaithe consideration teeskunnamo, every node in the network they will be updated in the table form. So that is the table based on the Bellman Ford algorithm, distributed Bellman Ford algorithm. దాని మీద బేస్ చేసుకొని దే విల్ బి అప్డేటెడ్ ద టేబుల్. సో ఇన్కార్పొరేటెడ్ టేబుల్ అప్డేట్స్ విత్ ఇంక్రీజింగ్ ద సీక్వెన్స్ నెంబర్ ట్యాగ్స్ టు ప్రివెంట్ ద లూప్స్. సో ఎక్కడ మనకి లూప్స్ రాకుండా ప్రివెంట్ లూప్స్ అనేది దే విల్ బి బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది సీక్వెన్స్ నెంబర్ ని బేస్ చేసుకొని దే విల్ బి అప్డేటెడ్. టు కౌంట్ ది కౌంటర్ ది కౌంట్ టు ద ఇన్ఫినిటీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. సో ఫాస్ట్ కన్వర్జెన్స్ విల్ బి టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ బిట్వీన్ ద source to destination. So table routing protocol routes the destination rapidly available at every node at all time. So every node there will be immediately fast convergence will be takes place between the exchanging between the neighbors at regular intervals to keep up to date across the network topology in the tables. Okay, the tables are forwarded if the node observes the significant changes in the local topology. So the updates updated are two types of updated will be takes place in the tables whenever the exchanging the information across the nodes. So first one is incremental update and full dumps. Okay, incremental update okati full dumps. Okay, ee rendittini manam consideration iskuntam. What is meant by incremental update means it takes a single network data packet unit, while full dump is multiple network data packet unit. Single network data packet consideration తీసుకుంటే incremental update. Fully dumped వచ్చేసరికి ఏందంటే multiple network packet unit తీసుకుంటే then it will becomes under the full dump. So incremental update are used for when the node does not observe significant changes in the local topology. So whenever you are on to transmit the source to the destination, the node does not changes frequently, only the one change will be takes place, then we will go for the incremental update. If the fully dumped is done, either local topology changes significantly, when the incremental update requires more than single network data packet unit, then we go for the full dump. Okay, full dump anedi epudu chestamante డేటా అప్డేటింగ్ అనేది సిగ్నిఫైంగ్ చేంజెస్ ఆఫ్ ది టోపాలజీ కండిషన్స్ అనేది తీసుకుంటే, లేదా మోర్ దాన్ సింగిల్ నెట్వర్క్ డంప్ డేటా డంపింగ్ అనేది తీసుకుంటే, సింగిల్ నెట్వర్క్ డేటా ప్యాకెట్ యూనిట్ అనేది కన్సిడరేషన్ తీసుకుంటే, దెన్ వీల్ చూస్ ద ఫుల్ డంప్ ఫర్ ద ప్యాకెట్ అప్డేటింగ్. సో ప్యాకెట్ అప్డేటింగ్ కి టూ ప్రొసెసర్స్ అనేది యూజ్ చేసుకుంటున్నాం. టూ ప్రొసెసర్స్ ఎలా తీసుకుంటాం అనేది ప్రెజెంటేషన్ అనేది తీసుకున్నాం. సో టేబుల్ అప్డేట్స్ ఆర్ ఇనిషియల్లీ ఇనిషియేటెడ్ బై ద డెస్టినేషన్ విత్ ఎ న్యూ సీక్వెన్స్ నెంబర్ which is always greater than previous one. So table updates anedi initiating ane ela iskuntam ante destination ki initiated by the destination with a sequence number always greater than the previous one. If you get the sequence number 10 at present transmission, next transmission of the data from neighbor node to the destination node, that will be greater than the sequence number of the 10. So always you will be choose the even sequence, which will be tells that will be successfully transmitted the data. So if the sequence number is odd, there is a problem that will be arised across that particular, there is link breakdown or anything will be obtained. Okay, so that is the representation here. So upon the receiving the updated table, a node either update to the tables based on the receiver information holds some time, and best metric will be obtained. So best metric means which is a number of lowest number of hops. So lowest number of hops will be connected means the shortest path for the transmission of the data source to the destination. Based on the sequence number of the table update, it is forwarded or rejected the table. So that is the representation of the packet transmission. So here you can see the node 1 to node 15, how the destinations will be take place, and global topology information will be updated across the tables. So you can see how availability of the node 5 and the distance is 4 hops. So here the table representation will be takes place. So manaki oka network ane teeskunam, network graph for the networking. So all the graphs in this routing protocol like this. So only links will be vary. Links diagram anedi itlane untundi. Links anedi edaithe connection links untayo avi change avutuntayi. Prathi daniki diagram ilane untundi. Table form untundi. Table untundi. At the same time it will be represents the network topology network. Okay. So here I taken some wireless ad hoc network. There are 1 to 15 nodes are present in the particular network. So source node 1 to source destination node is 15. We want to transmit the data. So 1 to 15. So here the destination node will be from 1 to 2, and next node is 2 for the destination, and the distance is 1. Only one connection will be, one hop connection will be takes place here. So that is considered as a distance as 1, and sequence number that will be allocated is 22. So whenever you are transmitted the data from 1 to 2, so destination and next node and distance and sequence number will be updated across all the nodes. Okay, and here next one is sequence destination is 3. So destination node is 3. And next node is 2, and destination distance is 2 from the source, and sequence number is 26. So you can check here, sequence number is always greater than the previous one. So that indicate that the information updating is successfully transmitted to every node, and they will know about the destination ID. So here we can finally reaches the 15th node. So next node is 5. And fourth destination is 4, and 256 is the updated information of the destination. So sequence number and the updated information and the like that it will be updated. So this is the route establishment in DSDV, distance sequence distributed sequence distance vector. Okay, this is the route established between in the source to the destination. Okay, so 4 and the which one take me to the 1 5 10, 12, 15. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4. Distance is 4. 4 links are the use case now. So, or you can choose the your next node and 5 on the ground. 1, 2, 5 on this command. So, 5 is the next node for that particular transmission. Okay. And if the path will be breakdown, if any chance of path will be breakdown, so what will be happen? So, reconstruction of the path used for ongoing data transmission section handled by the protocol is following. So here the end node of the broken link initiated the table update message is broken link await is assumed as infinity. So ekkadaithe breakdown anedi manaki vastundo, so there is initiated the some weightage of that particular infinite. So infinite anedi manaki ikkadaina kanapadthe, there is a link breakdown across that particular node. So with the sequence number greater than the stored sequence number from the destination, each node upon receiving the update weight updated with weight infinity quickly disestimated if it is neighboring in order to propagate the break and link information to the whole the network. So whole network ki breakdown anedi information anedi immediately velipothundi, already discussed chesam. So here single link break leads to the propagation of the table updating information whole network. So odd sequence number will be linked the wherever the breakdown will be differentiated. So manu ekkadaithe breakdown vastundo, sequence number anedi odd sequence istam, even anedi ichante successful ani artham. Okay na? So here some representation will be takes place here. So you can see the route maintenance. Route maintenance ante endante, ఎక్కడైనా బ్రేక్ డౌన్ వస్తే దెన్ ఇమీడియట్లీ దే విల్ బి ఇనిషియేటెడ్ దట్ బ్రేక్ డౌన్ విల్ బి ఇన్ఫార్మ్ టు ద సోర్స్ అండ్ సోర్స్ నోట్ విల్ బి ఇనిషియేటెడ్ దట్ దెర్ ఈస్ అ బ్రేక్ డౌన్ సో ఇమీడియట్లీ దే విల్ బి ఇనిషియేటెడ్ సో 11th నోడ్ దగ్గర మనకి బ్రేక్ డౌన్ అనేది వచ్చింది సో దట్ విల్ బి హైలైటెడ్ హియర్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ విల్ బి ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ పాత్ విల్ బి ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ బిట్వీన్ ద 1, 5, 10, 12, 15 ఇఫ్ ద బ్రేక్ డౌన్ విల్ బి అప్టైన్ సో ఒక నోడ్ అనేది దే విల్ బి మూవ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ సో బ్రేక్ డౌన్ విల్ బి అప్టైన్ అక్రాస్ ద 10 అండ్ 11 అండ్ 10 విల్ బి ఇనిషియేటెడ్ దట్ దర్ ఇస్ అ బ్రేక్ డౌన్ దట్ విల్ బి ఇన్ఫార్మ్ టు ద సోర్స్ నోడ్ అండ్ ఇమీడియట్లీ దే విల్ బి రీషెడ్యూల్స్ అండ్ విత్ సమ్ పీరియాడికల్ టైమ్ అండ్ అగైన్ ఇట్ బి ట్రాన్స్మిట్స్ ద డేటా విత్ అనదర్ ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ పాత్ విల్ బి ఐడెంటిఫై అనదర్ ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ పాత్ విల్ బి ఐడెంటిఫై దట్ ఈస్ ద రిప్రజెంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది డిఎస్టివి సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద అడ్వాంటేజ్ అండ్ డిసడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ది డిఎస్టివి యూ కెన్ సీ హియర్ So availability of the routes all the destination at all time implies that less delay in the involving the route setup process. So availability of routes anedi prathi okka information anedi they will be maintains the table. Every node they will know about the whatever the changes that will be obtained in the network. That information will be updated. So easily you can convey the data between the nodes. So delay anedi chanta ko untundi itlo. So incremental update with sequence number tags makes the existing wired network adapted in the ad hoc networks. Hence, the existing wired network protocol applied the ad hoc network fewer modification. The updates are propagated throughout the network. So, ये चिन्ना changes चेसना कोड़ा updates अनेदी मार्क immediate का up to date अनेदी networking topology लो update होते हैं. So, update due to the broken link leads to the heavy control overhead during the high mobility. एकु high mobility उन्ना पुरु मार्क की ఎప్పుడైతే ఈ బ్రేకింగ్ లింక్ అనేది వస్తుందో బ్రోకెన్ లింక్ అనేది వస్తుందో ఇమీడియట్లీ దే విల్ బి ఇనిషియేటెడ్ ద ఇన్ఫినైట్ సింబల్ అండ్ దట్ విల్ బి ఇనిషియేటెడ్ టు ద సోర్స్ దే విల్ బి అప్డేటెడ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ విల్ బి అప్డేటెడ్ టు ద ఆల్ ద నోడ్స్ సో దట్ విల్ బి హెల్ప్ఫుల్ ఇన్ ద రిప్రజెంటేషన్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిసడ్వాంటేజ్ మీన్స్ డిఎస్ విల్ బి ఆర్డర్ to obtain the information about the particular destination node the node has wait for the table update mission initiated by the same destination node the delay could not stall routine information will be ignored so manaki edaithe destination node anedi vastundo aa destination node daggara waiting period for the updating table anedi consideration teesukunnade appudu manaki time delay anedi adjustment anedi vastundi that is the disadvantage of the particular routing so second table driven routing protocols lo wrp anedi chana important so wireless routing protocol wireless routing protocol in the routing protocols okay so it is also very similar to the dsdv so inherent to the properties of the distributed bellman ford algorithm will be used here so in to counter the count to the infinity problem to enable the faster convergence it employs a unique method maintaining the information regarding to the shortest distance to every destination node so here they will be maintaining the shortest distance to every destination node in the network and penultimate hop node on the path of the every destination node hence wrb likely dsdv maintains the up to date view of the network every node has readily available to route the every destination in the network it differs from the dsdv table maintenance in the table update procedure so only it will be differs the table maintenance update procedure whole dsdv maintain only one topology table whereas coming to the wrp uses the set of tables maintains more accurate information about the convergence between the any changes in the network so the tables that be maintained by the node are followed by a distance table and routing table and link cost table and message retransmission list so ikkada four tables anedi use chestunnam instead of using the single table we are using the distance table routing table and link cost table and message retransmission list so distance table contains the network view of the neighboring of the nodes so distance table ante neighboring nodes anedi enta distance anedi consideration iskuntam what are the neighboring nodes across that particular distance anedi iskuntam it consists of the matrix where each element contains the distance anedi consider chestam distance table lo and the penultimate node reported by the neighbor for the particular destination so penultimate node anedi endante there will be reports by the neighbor for the particular destination so here this is the distance table so coming to the routing table consists of the up-to-date view of the network for all known destination. So in routing table, they will be maintains the up-to-date view of the network, whatever the changes for all known destination. With a node of a destination, and every node the graph, they will be presented. So it keeps the shortest distance and the preceding node and successor node, that means next node to reach the destination. Successor and next node that will be reaches to the destination. And if frog indicated the state of the path, a state lo represent chestunnam, present state anedi consider chestunnam. Simple path, correct, or loop and error, the destination node are not marked, that means nil. This is the path status. So simple path ante correct state anedi represent chestundi, loop anedi represent chesinamante error anedi represent chestundi, destination node not marked, so that is a nil. So coming to the LCT, that means link cost table anedi iskundam. So number of hopes to reach the destination, cost anedi endante number of hopes that will be reaches to the destination of relaying messages through each net link. The cost of the broken link is infinite. If the any link will be broken, then immediately here also that will be placed as a cost infinite. So it also consists of number of update periods passed since last successful update was received from that link. So broken link to partu, they will be maintain the number of updated periods passed since successful update or received across that particular receiver. So manaki okati broken links ni base chestundi, alane number of successful links ni kuda note chestundi LCT anedi. So this is done to detect the link breaks. It will be done to detect the link breaks. This is the LCT. And coming to the MRL, so MRL ku vachesarike endante message retransmission link, already meeku telusu ekkadaina manaku breakdown anedi vaste, again the retransmission of the messages will be entered into the source to the destination, that will be takes place here. So every updated message that is to be retransmitted and maintain a counter for every entry. ప్రతి ఒక్క ఎంట్రీని దే విల్ బి మెయిన్ ద కౌంటర్. సో డిసెన్ ద కౌంటర్ ఇస్ డిక్రిమెంటెడ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎవరీ రీట్రాన్స్మిషన్ ఆఫ్ ది అప్డేటెడ్ మెసేజ్. సో ఈచ్ అప్డేట్ మెసేజ్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది లిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ అప్డేట్స్, సో దట్ విల్ బి మెయింటైన్. ఓకే, దిస్ ఇస్ ద రిప్రజెంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది అప్డేట్. ఓకే, నైబరింగ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ని ఎలా ట్రాన్స్మిట్ చేస్తున్నాం అనేది ఈ రూటీన్ టేబుల్ అనేది యూజ్ చేసుకుంటున్నాం. ఓకే, దిస్ ఇస్ ద టేబుల్ రిప్రజెంటేషన్ అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ నోడ్ అండ్ ప్రొసీడర్ అండ్ కాస్ట్. Okay, cost and a number of hopes that will be transmitted from source to destination. This is the number of hopes and this is the procedure, next node and matadi procedure and a. So next node idi node a node nunchi manaki enta distance lo destination anedi undi, a node nunchi enta distance lo neighboring node anedi undi, ivanni root establishment of the path lo chustam. Any breakdown obtain, then immediately they will be retransmitted link will be considered here. So breakdown maintenance table vachesariki ee vidhanga untundi. Sorry, maintenance table vachesariki, this is the maintenance table. Here the breakdown will be obtained, so immediately the alternative route will be established between the 14 to the 15. So that is the main updating table will be considered here. So this is the wireless routing protocol. You will be must be explain the what is the internal operation, and also we can must be explain the source to destination. The source node will be flooded into the network and the data will be transmitted to the one node to the 15, and this is every node there will be know about the connection link between the destination node and preceding node and cost of that particular node, that will be maintained. Four tables ni maintain chestundi every node. That is the representation of the root maintenance in the WRP. So advantages chudandi, WRP is the same advantage as that DSTV. In addition, the faster convergence involved in the fewer table updates, but the complexity of the maintenance of the multiple table depends on the large memory and greater processor power. So instead of using the ad hoc wireless network, so from the nodes in the ad hoc network, high mobility and control overhead involved in the updating tables entries almost the same as that were DSTV. So not suitable for high dynamic and very large ad hoc networks. Large ad hoc networks valla suitable undadu, that is only disadvantage. Reason is you are maintaining the four tables, so that will be leads to the power consumption is very high and the memory also be very high. Okay, that is the drawback. Okay, advantage is sir, the fast convergence involves fewer table updates, very fast updating. So coming to the cluster head gateway switching routing protocol, we can discuss tomorrow cluster gated routing protocol on star star and rundu unnai aa rendu rate cheptam. Okay na, koncham lengthy kani koncham easy ga untundi, diagrams anni okela untai. So cluster head kuda like this. This is the diagram for the cluster head member and cluster head and normal node. This is the normal node and this is the cluster head and this is the cluster gateway. Gateway is the communicate within the one node to the another node, cluster head. Okay, we can discuss tomorrow. Okay, are you understanding all of you? And all of you attend the project classes. Don't miss the project classes. Okay, thank you.